engagingly gregarious, in egregious garrulity, the one and only Mr. Ronnie Corbett!
Me. Are you all right? Put me amongst the girls. Put me amongst the girls. Do me a favor. Do you know I'd do the same for you if you would put me amongst the girls. Those with the curly cut. Just a minute, please. Give it a sorry about that. Nobody hurt, I hope. Don't start now, please. I've just remembered a story I must tell you before I forget. Now listen, no, don't you come up. I'll come down there. Wait a minute. Now, I like to walk about a bit, you know, stretch my legs. Left it a bit late, haven't I? There we are.
So, there's a message from Robert.
Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. You're naughty down there, I can tell. Now, Mr. Sachs, the chairman, just told me that Ladysmith has fallen again. And Lord Smith says he's going to have the operation. Will you excuse my back? You'll excuse my front, I know. The ladies down here, they're all very, you know. If I slip off here, I might have more fun than I've had in years. Now, you're making up your own stories, that is. And I got specially dressed for you. See the nice new suit? Bought by my wife in the sale at Mother Care. When did you last buy a new suit and get a free womble? And I brought my medals. You see my wonderful medals? I'll tell you what, this one is actually a very, very particular medal. This medal was given by the American forces for outstanding action in the field. Belongs to my sister. Least said about that, the better. And this is the General Service Medal, and this is the Victory Medal, and this medal at the end here is awarded for the best whippet bitch of 1848. I got actually for running at school. And that one next to it for crawling at the BBC. There's a uniform I recognise down there. Wonderful, sir. Grand to see you. Royal Army Medical Corps. No, we lost my grandfather in the Royal Army Medical Corps. Fell out of bed while examining a patient. My dear old grandfather. Oh, dear. He fought in all the Zulu wars, you know. Well, not all of them, because he got fed up with blacking up every morning. I'm just going to sit down here and have a little bit of this snuff, because the doctor recommended it, you know, for nasal catarrh. It's very, very effective. Well, I've been taking it 2 days and I've already got nasal catarrh. He's a terrible doctor. I have to change him, actually. Terrible handwriting. He gave me a prescription the other day. I took it to the chemist. The chemist read it and said, all right, can you start Monday? Oh, we did have a laugh. Wish he was here tonight. But I...
doctor eventually gave me a wooden leg and a pair of scales. I mustn't sit and crease this, actually. I've got to be careful of this, because I'm booked to stand on a wedding cake tomorrow. You got my gloves, huh? Yes. Me and Hilda Baker will be standing there. Now, listen. That reminded me actually of a story, because talking about honeymoons and weddings, there's a story about a honeymoon couple, you see, that arrived in the hotel, in a honeymoon hotel. They booked in. Husband went into the bar. Wife went upstairs, got into bed. She'd only been in bed 3 minutes when this train passed the hotel. Shook the hotel. I nearly shook her out of bed. So she rang for the hotel manager, you see. And you're at it again, I knew that. She rang for the hotel manager. The hotel manager came out of the room, he knocked at the door. She said, you know, I've just been in this bed. This train has passed. It's nearly shook me out. The manager said, well, I can't understand that. He said, we've never had any complaints before about train vibrations. To which the bride... And the bride said, well, that's all very well, she said. I don't want any aggravation, she said, four eyes, but I'd just like you to know that when the next train passes this hotel, I'll tell us when it passes, but the manager said it passes about 3 minutes. So the bride said, would you mind just laying on this bed here? And I'll show you exactly what I mean when the train passes. No sooner had he laid on the bed when the door opened, in popped her husband. Husband said, I don't want to be inquisitive, but why are you lying there on the bed with my dear wife? The hotel manager said, now you're not going to believe this. But I'm just waiting for the 10:28 to Macclesfield. And the story I originally stopped the band to tell you has just come to my mind. Because I once took a train journey to a place not very far from here, Portsmouth. And I was sitting in this carriage, you see, with three sailors and a bishop. And we're all minding our own business. Well, the sailors are having a bit of fun, you know, trying on each other's hats. And this petty officer leans across the carriage and he touches the bishop on the knee. But it took us about 10 hours to get the bishop down off the luggage. He said, my lord bishop, he said, I'd like, this is a very well educated petty officer, actually. He said, my lord bishop, I'd like you to tell me, what is the gout? Bishop said, I'm very glad you asked me that, he said. I don't know why I said that, but that's what he said. I'm very glad you asked me. He said, gout is what you get from drinking too much, smoking too much, and going with Portsmouth ladies like Hospital Hattie and Lampo's Lou. Bishop said, why do you ask? The petty officer said, well, it says in here that the Archbishop of Canterbury's got it. When I sit and look at you, I just can't believe it's true. Can't believe you love me, though. You have often told me so. So it seems a dream of bliss. Never hoped for things like this. Now I'm wondering all the day why such luck should come my way. Fancy you fancying me. I can't tell what you can see, for it seems like dreams are not reality, that you should like my personality. I can't quite figure it out. I can't tell why it should be. I can fancy anybody fancying you, but fancy you fancying me. I'm going back up here. Could help liking you. You're so different from the rest. Suppose that's why I like you best. Guess the first day that we met, I knew I'd a heart to let. Now I'm wondering all the day why such luck should come my way. Fancy you fancying me. can see, for it seems like dreams are not reality, that you should like my personality. I can't quite figure it out. I can't tell why it should be. I can fancy anybody fancying you, but fancy you, fancying, fancy you, fancying, fancy you, fancying me. Fancy you, fancying.